So welcome, beautiful woman. I am so incredibly excited to do this live stream for you, as so many of my students, my clients, and women in my community have been asking me over and over again, how do I take care of myself? How do I take care of my nervous system and literally my mental sanity amongst this mental chaos? So thank you so much for being here with me today. If you're watching on live, then drop me a comment live. If you're watching on replay, then drop me a comment replay in the comments below, so I know exactly who is here with me and I can see Marina. Welcome, gorgeous. And let us dive right in. Hi, Sandra. Hi, beautiful soul. So in case you're new to my world, I want to say heartfelt welcome. My name is Dagmar Khan, and I am women's leading confidence and sexuality expert. And I deeply specialize on helping women skyrocket their mental and emotional confidence, completely fall in love with their bodies, and turn their pain into power so they can truly and completely focus on living their best life. And what we are experiencing nowadays is absolute global chaos. And without a question, the times are very, very challenging. People are getting sick. People are dying, people are losing their financial income, people are losing ability to travel, conferences, events, so many things are getting canceled. And the real question for all of us, as we are trying to literally get through this very, very difficult time, is how do I take care of myself? How do I take care of my nervous system? How do I take care of my sense of okayness? How do I maintain my sanity as the world as I know it is literally falling apart in front of my eyes and underneath of my feet? So I want to start a little bit by sharing my own story and how I came to experience that level of calm and collectedness that I'm feeling in myself. And I am bringing that to you. I am bringing that to my family. I'm sharing that with my son. I'm sharing that with my husband. I'm sharing that with my loved ones. And I want to say that it is a level of freedom. It is a level of priceless emotional freedom that no one can give you. It's something you have to create for yourself. But once you have it, no one can take it away from you. And it's incredibly, incredibly powerful and incredibly empowering. So for most of my life, all I knew was anxiety. All I knew was sense of dread. All I knew was incredible and really overwhelming sense of visceral fear. And even though I was practicing yoga, even though I was eating clean diet, even though I was, you know, thinking positively and doing my affirmations, I was still experiencing tremendous amount of visceral fear, tremendous amount of fear that is literally experienced at the level of the body. And no amount of yoga, no amount of meditation, no amount of green smoothies was really helping me address this like deep fear that sits in my gut, deep fear that sits in my heart. And what I'm seeing, without a question, as I'm speaking to women, as I'm speaking to my clients, as I'm speaking to my students, is with what is happening right now, this is the level of fear is activated for most people really at the level of their organs, at the level of their viscera. There is a sense of tremendous dread. There is this sense of tremendous activation, tremendous alarm, and nothing seems to be calming it down. Nothing seems to be taking that dread away. So what I want to share with you today is both like a bigger picture thing that I want you to step into, and simultaneously a very tangible, powerful, effective, and incredibly simple technique that you can do in less than 2 minutes, in less than 2 minutes, that will completely shift your physiology, that will completely shift in how you feel and what you hold true to about yourself, what you hold true about your physiology and how you are moving into the rest of the day. So who is excited to receive some life-changing education and some profoundly empowering skills that will actually completely change the fabric and the narrative of your day? So if you're excited, drop me some hearts, drop me some love, show me your questions, show me your excitement in the comments below, and let us dive right in. So the big picture, what do you really need to stay calm and collected? What do you really need to keep your nervous system at a level of calm in this mental chaos? The bigger picture is that you need to proactively manage your mind. You need to proactively manage your mind. So what do I mean by that? If your day looks like that, you wake up in the morning and literally your phone is sleeping with you, and the first thing you get up in the morning and you start scrolling on BBC and on social media, like checking in what is going on, that is not being proactive about your mindset. That is literally reacting into the realities of the world. Now, I am not taking away the need from you that you want to stay informed. Of course you want to stay informed. Of course you want to know how is the world doing. Of course you want to check on your loved ones. Of course you need to understand the pulse of what is going on. But you need to get it done. You need to do it in a way that is done in what I call in consent with your body, in consent with your physiology. So this is a massive call for some powerful mental boundaries, mental and energetic boundaries with yourself that are at the core designed to keep you safe and in this, like in the space of boom, right, collectedness, rather than just falling apart. So I was just speaking to one of my clients this morning, and we were having discussion in our Slack channel, which is part of my Flourish Academy, where I like literally every single day with my clients, I'm answering their questions and really, really supporting them every step of the way. And we're having discussion about, you know, how you're taking care of yourself, like what is going on for you. And I said to my client, it's like, you know, you are not allowed to check your phone the first thing in the morning. Simple. You cannot check your phone first thing in the morning. This is, you're literally not allowed. So let me give you a very simple framework of how to start your day that is actually designed to create foundation of safety and calmness inside of your body and inside of your nervous system. Ready? So the first step is you get up in the morning, you wake up in the morning, you do not look at your phone. That's step number one. You do not look at your phone. Like your phone is literally turned off. It's in different bedroom. It's in different part of your home. You do not look at your phone. The step number two is you have to hydrate your system. You have to hydrate your system top to bottom. Throughout the night, you are losing a lot of liquid, so you need to drink 2 glasses of water. Now, if you have a very specific medical condition where you're maybe like not absorbing fluids, or fluids, a lot of fluids at once are actually irritating your condition. I know it is true with some folks who might have Crohn's disease, some form of autoimmune diseases. So if this is true for you, then obviously you do something that's in alignment with, you know, taking care of yourself. But for most people, this guideline around having 2 glasses of water first thing in the morning works really, really well. The third thing is you gotta do abdominal massage. You gotta do abdominal massage. And very shortly after I share this big picture framework with you, I will be changing my perspective here, and I will be inviting Oscar, my skeleton, on our screen. I'll be actually sharing with you what abdominal massage is, and I will take you step by step through how the abdominal massage looks, what it does for you, and how it will tremendously help you stay calm and centered and collected during these challenging times. So step number one, do not look at your phone. Step number two, you gotta drink 2 glasses of water. Step number three, you'll do abdominal massage that we're gonna break down together, which is like having a superpower in your pocket. I cannot lie, this is having a superpower in your pocket. Step number four, you gotta get out and have at least 15 minutes of daylight. Now, if you are in a country like myself, I'm in Ireland and it is raining. Like for last 3 months, we have storm after storm after storm. So there are some mornings that is like beautiful and I can absolutely apply it and, you know, take in this absolutely essential daylight and sunlight that my system needs. And there are many mornings that is just not an option, right? It's raining, it's stormy, it's super windy. The sunlight is not there, but definitely getting the daylight into our system, it's so incredibly important. Now, even today, you know, like it got really heavy in Ireland, literally last night, because last night our government has announced like shutting down of schools and nurseries and most of the events. So like literally the energy in Ireland got really, really heavy. And this morning, like me and my husband were feeling it, like we are at home, we are having our breakfast, and I'm literally feeling almost like this impact of being between the four walls and the heaviness of it. And I said to my husband, like, hey, babes, like, let's just get out. Let's go and get coffee. Let's change our perspective. Let's see people. And literally we stepped out. We got a coffee, we saw a couple of people, like we walk around the town and our perspective has shifted, like literally just letting our eyes to wander, right? And take in different scene, different vision, seeing other people around us, connecting with other people. Although I know that's like about 15 minutes, right? It's not recommended, but seeing other people just allowed me to definitely shift my perspective and get out of a little bit of like a subtle mental funk that I was getting myself into and make me feel tremendously better. So step number four, you gotta get out for at least 15 minutes and take in your environment, like take in the grass and the trees and the houses and the people, or maybe no people depending on where you are, but you need to get into your system a daylight. And step number five in this morning framework, you need to wait at least 90 minutes till you get coffee in your system. You gotta wait at least 90 minutes till you get coffee in your system. This is really, really important. And the reason for that is, first and foremost, after you have hydrated and you've done the abdominal massage, which again, I'll be breaking down very shortly, the abdominal massage is so incredibly helpful for inviting the absorption of nutrients and deep hydration, deep visceral hydration of your tissues. And your system needs time for this to really, really take place. If you start right after abdominal massage, if you start sipping on coffee, that absorption and hydration of your tissues is literally not an option in your system. The second thing is, the moment you get coffee into your system, obviously your adrenaline spikes up. And I can almost guarantee you, and I'm curious, as I say that, how many of you can see yourself in this? The moment you get coffee in your system, your mind goes into hyper alert, and automatically you're finding yourself like reaching for the phone or reaching for the laptop and like wanting to react, wanting to check, wanting to see what's going on. It's like almost you're in this hyper alertness, like boom, ready for flight, ready for attack, ready for like literally pulling all this energy out of your organs into your muscles, getting ready for attack. So ideally, in an ideal world, we all get off of our coffees, right? This is an ideal world, but it's definitely a long way to go. But the minimum you can do for yourself is really wait that 90 minutes, have the 90 minutes window in the morning so you can allow your cells to regenerate and like really allow that regeneration response and enough time for tissue hydration before you actually get your coffee into your system. So to recap, before we dive into the abdominal massage, is step number one, don't look at your phone. Step number two, drink 2 glasses of water. Step number three, do your abdominal massage. Step number four, get out for at least 15 minutes. Take in the daylight, take in the sun. And step number five, wait for 90 minutes till you have your coffee. So I'm gonna change my setup because I'm gonna invite my skeleton, my personal assistant, to be on a screen with us. And as I'm changing my situation, how about you ask me, how about you let me know what questions you have for me as I have shared this framework with you. This morning routine framework. So shoot your questions. Let me know what is alive for you and how you're receiving this. Whoop. How you're receiving this. Okay. This should work. All right. So this is my assistant. His name is Osteo. His name is Osteo. And Osteo has been so kind to show you today, the single most important muscle in your body, which is the physiological doorway in helping you stay calm and collected. Now, what I'm about to share with you is something I wish every single woman on this planet knows, because A, it is your birthright to know your diaphragm. And second, when you know your diaphragm and when you know how to release stress from your diaphragm, it's like having a superpower in your hands. It is having a superpower in your hands. So you ready for this? So let's assume that this is your diaphragm. This is obviously a softball, not your diaphragm. In case you haven't heard about your diaphragm is, hi Harmony, hi gorgeous. Your diaphragm, once again, is the single most important muscle in the body. There are actually a couple of different diaphragms. There is a pelvic floor diaphragm, and the diaphragm we are talking about is a respiratory diaphragm. So your diaphragm, the reason why this is a single most important muscle in the body is it's a muscle of breathing. This is a muscle of breathing. And I have a really fun question for you right now. I'm curious how well you know your body. You definitely know very well what's going on in the world. How about how well do you know your body? So the question I have for you, and I want you to let me know your thoughts in the comments below, is how many times do you breathe every single day? How many times do you breathe every single day? And the first person who gives me a correct answer about how many times you breathe every single day is going to get a very special gift. So I'm very curious to hear your answers. So in a process, as I'm waiting for your answers, I'm going to teach you some basics on the diaphragm. The diaphragm, throughout what's called an abdominal breath, does a very specific movement. On inhale, the diaphragm contracts and it pushes downwards towards the abdominal viscera. And on exhale, the diaphragm flies up towards its natural resting position between lungs. So in a world, well, let's assume you are quite relaxed and you know your diaphragm. This is a movement that your diaphragm does a lot throughout the day. And this is a movement that you absolutely want to get in your system. The reason for that is that when your diaphragm moves in this way, it creates tremendous relaxation in your system, top to bottom. You have your lungs and your heart sitting on top of diaphragm, and beneath your diaphragm, you have all of your abdominal organs, your stomach, your liver, your intestines, and this movement actually massages your viscera, abdominal viscera. It also massages your heart. It's incredibly, incredibly helpful and something that you want to stay in most of your day. So Sandra says about 20,000 times. Oh my goodness. Yes, gorgeous woman. Carla says between 17,000 and 23,000 times per day. That's some ninja answers. These are my students. Carla and Sandra, they have been hearing me teaching about it for quite some time, which is amazing. So yes, both answers are correct. Both answers are correct. So both Carla and Sandra are going to get a special gift from me for their participation and amazing answer. So here is what I want you to know. Here is what I want you to know that's happening right now for most people because they are in this panic mode. When you get in a panic mode, you no longer breathe with your diaphragm. Instead, you're using the muscles of your neck, like your scalenes and your upper clavicular muscles, and you breathe like this. Now, this, first and foremost, is incredibly stressful on your system, incredibly stressful. And the equivalent of this I can give you is when you have your smartphone, whether you're using iPhone or using Android, and you have a lot of apps running on your phone, right? What happens to your phone? Your phone gets recharged very, very fast. And the same holds true for your system. When you're not using your diaphragm to breathe because you're stressed, because you're anxious, because you're worried, because you're apprehensive, because you don't know how to access your diaphragm, because your diaphragm maybe holds a lot of emotional tension, what happens is the diaphragm doesn't move. Again, you're breathing instead with these upper neck muscles, your scalenes and your upper clavicular muscles. And that is making you incredibly, incredibly susceptible to anxiety, to stress, to tremendous dysregulation in your nervous system, to feeling completely off, and most importantly, not having the strength, not having like this mental and emotional bandwidth to take your next step, to do what is necessary, to maintain your calm and your collectedness. So the gift I want to give you today is what I shared with you about the morning routine, right? The abdominal massage is the third part of your morning routine. I want to teach you an abdominal massage that will actually get into your diaphragm and allow you to release your diaphragm, allow you to have an embodied sense of your diaphragm, and most importantly, let all of these upper back and upper neck muscles to stop firing so you can start employing your diaphragm for breathing, which is the single fastest way to break down the stress physiology, is the single fastest way to help yourself feel like human again. And it is the gift I wanna give you right now. So, who is excited? This is my most favorite thing on the planet to teach, and I'm about to share this with you right now, and I'm really, really excited. So, what you will need for this is a softball. This is a ball from the Tune Up Fitness Method. It's called, you'll probably see that, it's called Gorgeous Ball. And I'm going to link a link to getting your Gorgeous Ball. If you're in States, the company is actually in California. and by neck pain. Yes, Jemima, neck pain and stress in the diaphragm are so interconnected, and this has a potential to ameliorate your neck pain. Absolutely. So Gorgeous Ball, you can get it from States very easily. It's a Californian company, so they will ship like within 2 or 3 days. If you are in Europe, I'm going to link a website for Europe as well. It's a company in UK, it's called stressnomore.co.uk. If you already have Gorgeous Ball, you can do this with me right now. And outside of that, another thing you can use is literally equivalent of this, like a soft Pilates ball that you do Pilates exercise with. The key here is that the ball is soft. Don't put a hard football on your diaphragm. That's gonna hurt, and that can create a lot of dysfunction. It has to be a soft ball, soft, pliable, and light, so you actually are safely getting into your diaphragm and into your viscera. Hi, Dominique. Hello, beautiful soul. So lovely to see you today. So what I'm going to do is reorient myself. So you will see me actually lying down, and I'm going to show you this abdominal massage and this process of getting into your diaphragm in a step-by-step way. Shall we? So let me take out my top, and as I'm setting myself up, let me know what questions you have for me in the comments below. It will be really, really beautiful to see what is alive and how you are receiving this information. So Eva is in the house. Hello, gorgeous soul. And Angelique, welcome, beautiful woman. So if you're just jumping on, I will be showing a process of getting into your diaphragm with a gorgeous ball. So you can, in a simple way, in a 2 minutes way, help ameliorate a lot of stress and a lot of tension and actually get into your physiology in a way that allows you to breathe like human and get calm and collected. All right. So, allow me to readjust. And I wanna make sure that you can see me really well. All right. So where are we going with the ball? Whether you're just gonna watch this or you're going to do this with me, is you want to get the ball right beneath your breast. So it's not on the breast, it's not on the belly. The access to the diaphragm on the front line is really in this uppermost part of your gut, the lowest most part of your ribcage. So what I'm doing, and I'll probably need to adjust it a little bit more. Let's see if this is working. Probably not. We need a tiny bit more light. Okay. It's quite dark here, isn't it? Okay, let me try and adjust the light so there is more light coming in. You can actually see the ball in my diaphragm. So I'm hoping this is... It's kind of not better for whatever reason. Okay, let us try this. Ha! This is what we're talking about. Okay, great. So the ball is, again, right under my breast. And what I'm doing is I'm lying face down. So my body weight is literally creating a pressure, right? It's creating pressure. And I'm feeling some resistance in the diaphragm. So what you're going to do is take a deep breath. So you're breathing and you're literally swelling the tissues against the ball. That's a movement of diaphragm that creates that. On top of the inhale, you'll create a tension, a lot of tension, almost as if you're creating a blood pressure cuff in your abdominal wall. And on exhale, you release, you let it go, and you soften, you de-armor the tissues of the ball. So let me say it again, and let me show it to you maybe this way. So on inhale, I am taking a deep breath, letting the diaphragm descend into the ball. On top of the inhale, I'm creating a tension, so there is a lot of
contraction in the abdominal wall. The diaphragm is in tension position. And on exhale, I'm softening my tissues over the bowel. So as you do this a few times, you're literally employing the diaphragm. So you can see that my neck muscles are not moving. My upper back muscles are not involved in breathing. I'm really using my diaphragm to create this motion. And then of course I can let myself move from side to side. So there is a motion across this diaphragm wall. And oh my goodness, I can feel some pockets of tension and restriction in this diaphragm wall. So this is a process that you literally step into first thing in the morning. First thing in the morning to prime the engine, and you spend, you know, somewhere between 2 to 5 to 10 minutes on your diaphragm, creating regulation and release of subconscious and unconscious fears and holding in the diaphragm, so your whole body can actually start to breathe better breath. You can start to breathe better breath. And what you will start to find is you will experience a lot of release, like this unconscious holding, or like a lot of conscious stress that you have been holding in your midline. You'll immediately start to breathe better. Like you'll have access to more breath. And I can almost guarantee you, when you have access to more breath, you're going to feel better instantly. This is not a thing you affirm yourself towards. It's not something you visualize yourself towards. This is something your physiology takes over. And it is the freedom that I wish every single woman on this planet have. Because literally, if you are breathing in a way that fosters calm and collectedness, you are creating the bandwidth, you're creating a space, you're creating a possibility consciousness for yourself to literally get through your day. And I have something funny to share. I have a candle on the right side of me, and I had my dress over it, and look what has happened. I have burned my own dress. Oh my goodness, and this has been a new dress. I am not happy about it. But guess what? My diaphragm is so relaxed that I'm literally laughing over that. Like this is not going to destroy me. This is not going to make me upset. I'm so blessed to be here with you today. I'm so blessed to be sharing this with you, and little burn dress, like what the hell? My diaphragm feels amazing. So couple of things around the diaphragm release is, when you do this, especially for the first time, you might start to feel a lot of emotions. You might start to feel a lot of access to emotions or emotional states that maybe you did not have access to, that maybe you are not consciously aware of. And you might be surprised to feel maybe a arrival of sadness. You might be surprised to feel maybe a lot of rage, a lot of anger. More often than not, and this really goes to the part of this training, which is all about, you know, how emotional healing will actually create more possibility for you in these challenging times. More often than not, underneath of all of this anxiety and fear, there are deeper emotions that are really waiting to be felt and experienced. And the deeper emotions are usually sadness, shame, and rage. Sadness, shame, and rage. So this morning, over the last 2 days, I was feeling this like little wave of sadness coming up. But I had a sense like I'm not able to access it. It's just like crawling in the depths of me, but is not coming up. It's not coming up. And this morning, me and my husband, we had a conversation, and my husband is like this little like a news reporter. Like he reports all the realities of this country, and this amount of people are sick here, and this is what's happening in Ireland, and this is what's happening in UK. And he's little like this news reporter. And I could feel this morning, and it was literally so interestingly enough, it was 10 minutes after the Diaphragm release, that I had this wave of sadness coming up, and I felt very strong, like push off for him. It's like, hey, enough, like stop this, to create a space for the sadness to come up. And I found myself crying, and it was really, really deep. The cry was very, very deep, and very, very healing. And it was something that really had to be released. I had to give myself permission to be emotional and sit with my sadness and allow the sadness, instead of just like shoving it down and suppressing it and letting more anxiety or fear take over, like cover up over the sadness. So when you begin to access this deep physiological tissue, which once again is the single most important muscle in your body, and you being here with me today, and you watching this live, and you being in this community, there is 18 of us right now watching live, which is amazing. Thank you so much for doing that. We are so blessed to have our diaphragm. We are so blessed to have this incredible physiological tissue that gives us so much doorway for living this day and being with our loved ones and having the possibility of better tomorrow. Yes, it's true that our future is very uncertain. Our future holds a lot of question, and is the uncertainty, this uncertainty that can create a lot of emotional pain and confusion and wounding and stress and anxiety. But what we do have moment-to-moment control, what we do have moment-to-moment access, is our ability to A, choose how we feel, choose what we focus on, choose what we, you know, invest our time and energy into. And if we find ourselves in the loops of like, I am not able to manage myself, maybe I've spent, you know, 2 hours reading news and I just feel flooded with stress from inside out, then it's my responsibility to change my environment and take care of myself. Sometimes the taking care of myself, it's what in Ireland they love to do, is having a cup of tea with biscuits. It's not a bad thing, but unfortunately that's not going to break down your stress physiology. But this simple tool of accessing your diaphragm in a body-based way is the single most effective tool that will help you instantly feel better. Because the truth is, how does your diaphragm, so does the rest of your body. How does your diaphragm, so does your nervous system. How does your diaphragm, so does your perception. So for those of you who are, who have done a lot of work in a nervous system field, maybe you are a psychotherapist, maybe you're a coach, maybe you're in trauma resolution work yourself. This is a bottom-up approach, right? This is subconscious to conscious approach. And I'm not gonna lie, there are things that need to happen at the conscious level to like create a full integration. Meaning, when you liberate the subconscious pattern in your diaphragm, there are new, a thinking habits that have to happen. There are new psychological perceptions that have to be adopted. And this is something what I do in a really, really deep way with my students and with my clients. But for now, if you start accessing your diaphragm, it is really going to create a massive shift in how you feel and a massive shift in helping you release in this visceral way so much of your stress. So as we are coming towards the end, I want to know what questions you might have for me. I'm going to check actually my laptop as well, so I can see really, really well. I can see way better some of anything that's coming up. I don't see anything. So please, if you have a question about diaphragm release, if you have a question about anything we have done, if you have a question about how to better deal with stress, if you want to understand maybe your own response and maybe how you feel and what you need to do specifically in order to stay calm and collected in the uncertain times, this is your time to ask the question. If you're watching on replay, then you have a full permission and I'm inviting you to ask this question because it has a potential to change the course of your day, the course of your next day, the course of your next week. To me personally, knowing this and applying this is a responsibility I have, both for myself and obviously for my beautiful son. I strongly believe, as a mother who deeply believes, that I have responsibility. I have responsibility to my son to create a loving, safe, and secure environment, even as these times are chaotic, even as these times are uncertain. I have a responsibility towards my son to be my best self and really apply the knowledge, apply the tools, apply myself in a way that actually fosters calmness and love and connection in my environment and in my relation to my son, because my son cannot suffer due to my inability or unwillingness to better manage my stress. I have a responsibility as a mother to manage my stress, apply the tools, take a conscious control of how I take care of myself and what I invite into my system so I can be present there with him every step of the way and really support his health, well-being, growth, and evolution. So Marina asks, have you got any more tips for releasing neck and shoulder tension except this massage, which seems wonderful, and thank you for that. Yes, certainly. So over next couple of days, I will be doing a series of lives on helping you take good care of yourself through these uncertain times. And I will teach you in probably on Saturday exactly how to take care of neck and shoulder, which will... there'll be partially difficulty in the diaphragm, stress in the diaphragm, but there'll be also other tissues involved. So I'll be super happy to teach you very effective ways of specifically addressing like a deeply held tension in the levator scapula, in the upper trapezius, in the occipitals, and helping you eradicate this tension and feel better in your body. Dominique says, when my body is in much pain in the muscles again and I'm doing the midline high reading almost every morning and meditations of you regularly, what can I do more? So I'll probably need to understand a little bit more. So you're doing high reading in midline and you're doing our meditations, which is amazing. It sounds like your pain is activated. If I'm understanding this right, you can definitely let me know more in the comments. My sense would be that your nervous system is going in massive activation. Your nervous system is going in like a lot of maybe fear and taking on the stress and the chaos of the world. And I would say probably the next best thing, Dominique says yes, the next best thing is I would go into the abdominal massage. So you're actually addressing the entire viscera, you're addressing the entire abdominal system, you're getting tissue hydration and circulation into your organs, into your intestines, into your diaphragm, into your womb, and really... improving, or shall I say, ameliorating the pain you're experiencing, like this global pain that you're experiencing, by enhancing the health of your gut. I'm not really anxious for this virus. Okay, great, that's amazing. But there might be, it sounds like there's again the activation in the nervous system. So what I'm gonna invite you, gorgeous, is start inviting the abdominal massage into your hydrating midline routine, into your morning routine, and see how you get on over the next couple of days and see how your body responds to that. So Eva says, I notice my stress is gathering on my lower back. Would you have any tips on that? Yes, gorgeous. So Eva has worked with me in Flourish Academy, which part of that is a lot of self-massage techniques. So I believe, gorgeous, that you have a full lower back sequence with the therapy balls that is specifically designed on addressing lower back pain, lower back tension. So you can go to that, gorgeous. You can go to the bonus program you got, the Tune Up Fitness program, and there's an entire lower back sequence that very deeply focuses on the QL, which is the quadratus lumborum, the deepest of your lower back muscles. And I would say that will be tremendously, tremendously helpful for you. If you combine it with the abdominal massage, the abdominal massage also dramatically improves health of the lower back. The muscle that connects like the front of the abdomen with the lower back is the transverse abdominis. And what I have found in my own experience and working with so many people around chronic lower back pain or lower back pain in general is addressing and releasing the tension, the holding in the transverse abdominis actually impacts the health of the lower back and really provides a lot of soothing release. Eva says, I release my tension through crying. Yes. So this further like deepens what I was sharing, that with emotional release, right, it fosters a lot of healing, emotional release, like really holding your emotions sacred and allowing yourself to be in whatever arises, the sadness, the anger, the rage, the uncertainty, the not knowing, allowing yourself and holding yourself sacred in these oftentimes very difficult emotional states is profoundly liberating and deeply, deeply healing for your body. So if you want to go deeper, like way deeper on this stuff, I have a very special invitation. I'm going to get to the further questions, but I want to announce this. So I have a free 3-day challenge. We have a free 3-day challenge coming up March 19th to 21st. That's next week, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And over the 3 days, I'll be teaching you a life-changing processes, mindset habits, and really vision for yourself that will allow you to create profound peace in every cell of your body, in every cell of your being. So this is a Flourishing Woman 3-day challenge happening inside of our private Facebook group called Flourishing Woman. The link to get in, the link to sign up is in the description of this video. I'll be also posting the link in the comments after I finish the live stream. It's a one-click registration. That's all you need to do, one-click registration, and you will get messages from me inside of Messenger. And once again, this 3-day challenge, I'm not gonna lie, has the potential to really change the course of your life, really change how you hold yourself, how you take care of yourself, what you hold true about yourself in these uncertain times, in these challenging times. It is something I really would not want you to miss. It is something that I believe is the best investment of your time and energy. It's absolutely free. There are no strings attached. And my vision with this 3-day challenge, with this Flourishing Woman 3-day challenge, March 19th and 21st, is to deeply support you and empower hundreds of women around the globe to deeply understand their bodies and know how to create profound peacefulness in every cell of their being, because there is no more important time than now to know how to do this and create this for yourself. So once again, one click registration on the description of this video, or you can simply go, let me actually read this for you. It is bit.ly /flourish March. bit.ly/flourishmarch will get you signed in to the 3-day challenge that has potential to change the course of your life and truly learn a life-changing tools and skills that will allow you to create peacefulness and pleasure in every cell of your being. So Sandra says, I'm having nightmares over it than insomnia. Okay, this is really, really excellent. And thank you so much for sharing this. With nightmares and then insomnia, this is a sign of tremendous overactivation in the nervous system. So what I would want you to do is establish a night routine. I spoke a lot about morning routine, right? How to start your day. But for this, you actually need a night routine to literally discharge the impact of your day on your system and create a peacefulness and collect yourself, put yourself together in a really really beautiful way. So Sandra is in I believe my Sexy Confidence membership. In the Breathwork Gorgeous, there is a practice called bone breathing. And I would definitely try this tonight. Bone breathing is really about literally breathing into your bones, like focusing on your bones, breathing in your bones, nourishing your bones. And what that does, it creates a deep settling in your system, a deep grounding and balancing of your system from skin all the way down into your bones. And my sense is this will really allow you to get very, very deeply grounded and, a step into your sleep in a way that actually allows you to sleep comfortably and peacefully. Now, if this, definitely give it a try today and see how you're getting on. If this doesn't work, then the next step would be to actually really, in a conscious way, discharge the activation from your nervous system. And the best way to do it is to do a gentle breath work. Now, I am way bigger fan of breath work for these challenging times than for meditation. And the reason for that is, especially if you do hold a lot of anxiety, if your nervous system is like a collector for stress, the meditation, like being still, even if you have guided meditation, it can make you feel almost like trapped in your system. And there might be a sense of, I just want to run away. I want to like literally, get outside of this, or like run away from this experience. There is so much intensity in your system. So what I would love for you is to do, that is a gentle, I don't exactly know what the name is, but a gentle breath work, which in a really gentle and soothing way allows you to discharge some of this activation and ameliorate a lot of this pattern of overthinking, overanalyzing, being in your mind, being in your head, and in a soothing way, get you into your body, get you into your nervous system, which is, oh my God, life-changing. It is life-changing to fall asleep in a way where your conscious mind is slightly shut down and your conscious mind is more relaxed and open and you're actually more in your body. It's really, really beautiful. And I have a sense, I actually had a client last year who had incredible nightmares, and it was coming a lot from a lot of shame and a lot of difficulty in her family, a lot of difficult emotional interactions, and doing a gentle breath work before sleep has absolutely changed how she sleeps every single night. It has been very, very powerful. So I'm holding the same vision for you, gorgeous, and definitely give it a try and let me know how you're getting on. So Sylvia says, do you have any more suggestion for experiencing the emotions that may come up with diaphragm massage? Whew, this is a deep question. And the answer is, it depends. I would say for most women, it will be either sadness or rage. Sadness or rage. So if you have sadness coming up, then the best guidance I can give you, gorgeous, is to allow yourself to quote unquote fall apart for a couple of minutes. Allow yourself to cry. Allow yourself, hold your tears, hold your sadness sacred. Allow the sadness to release, to release, to release. It might be like this healing river just pouring out of your diaphragm and giving you this life-changing freedom, this life-changing free experience that will really create a deep healing inside of you. If you find on the other side that it's more rage that you're experiencing, which is not uncommon, especially for women who have experienced a lot of manipulation, a lot of control, a lot of exploitation in their childhood growing up, maybe from previous partner, maybe they have been abusive or narcissistic relationship, there can be a lot of rage that sits in the diaphragm. And probably the simplest way to dislodge some of this rage is screaming, is, you know, getting into your car, closing the windows, and letting like that rage, that intensity of rage, to be taken out of your system. It's very, very powerful, and it really allows this deeply held rage to be released and discharged, and bring your diaphragm more into neutrality. So Dominique says thanks. Deva says thank you so much. Okay, Sandra says I'll try that. Thanks. Okay, gorgeous woman. So to recap, first and foremost, I have an invitation for you to join me for a free Flourishing Woman 3-day challenge starting next week, Thursday, March 19, 2021. But you're going to learn a life-changing tools and skills that will allow you to create peace in every cell of your being and create a vision for yourself that allows you to feel amazing even in these uncertain times. This 3-day challenge is absolutely free, and it is my gift to you because I really, really want to support you in these very turbulent times. You can get in and sign up with one click. There's a link on this video, or you simply go to bit.ly/flourishmarch, and that will give you all the information, get you fully booked in a royal way. The second thing is I'm inviting you to start a morning routine. And to recap the steps, the step number one, do not look at your phone. It's very, very harmful. Don't look at your phone. Step number two, you gotta drink 2 glasses of water to hydrate your system top to bottom. Step number three, you're gonna do abdominal massage. So in the middle of this video, I was breaking down the abdominal massage for you. You will need a soft inflated ball. The best ball for this is the Gorgeous Ball from Tune Up Fitness Method. The second option is a soft Pilates ball that people do that Pilates exercises with, and you gotta release your diaphragm and create a doorway into better breath. You gotta have better breaths. The step number four is spend 15 minutes outside, get in some daylight, get in some sunlight, change your environment, allow fresh breath to come into your system. And step number five, don't have your coffee for minimum 90 minutes. So this is all from me for today. Also, I'm going to invite you to share this video in Messenger, in a Facebook group that you are part of, on your wall, so more women can understand this very simple framework that is so simple, yet so incredibly effective when it comes to dealing with stress physiology and helping you and helping another amazing woman like yourself stay calm and collected in these times. We are in this together, and I have no question that when we really make a priority to take good care of ourselves, we can deal and overcome and better manage so much of this visceral anxiety that is coming up for a lot of people. And of course, I have the same intention and the same vision for you, gorgeous woman. So sending you much, much love. Thank you so much for being here with me today. Thank you so much for watching on replay. If you're watching on replay, you are amazing. And together, we are better. Together, we are better.